how annoyed you are with breakfast. It's that time of the year when we're heading back to work, and the last thing we want to be doing, well, some of us have been back for a little while, after a long day of slaving over a hot stove. The lovely Sarah Tuck joins us today with her favourite easy but delicious summer salads that will use up all of your leftovers as well.
Mm-hmm. Hold your magazine up, Dish. Oh, so right. Sarah's the editor of Dish. It is a really fantastic New Zealand magazine. Where is it? There it is. And that's out at the beginning of Feb, right?
It is, 8th of Feb. So Monday week.
Right. Now, Sarah was telling a lovely story, and that is, so when our youngsters heard Sarah was coming in and she was doing salads, they went, ugh. Yeah. And then they see the salad, so you've obviously got some fillet and some chicken in it, protein, and they're going, too.
Yeah, definitely. Salads get a bad rap that they don't deserve. Yeah.
But these are just small. Oh,
yeah.
What's that one?
The what? So
this is a sambal chicken salad.
Oh, yeah, hold on. I'm just using my, used my pen.
I should have bought utensils. Yeah.
That's good. That's classic. Fred Flintstone's in the house.
Delicious. That's with marinated chicken, and it's got this fantastic coconut dressing, which is insanely good. That's good, isn't it?
So good.
So good. So you can...
It's
super easy to make, after work, because if you just chuck the chicken thighs and don't use chicken breasts, chicken breasts are a bit mean, chicken thighs have got a lot more...
Juice.
They're just a lot more tender, in terms of cooking. Chicken breasts can dry out really easily. So this is chicken thighs in a marinade, and you just chuck it in the fridge in the morning and cover it in glad wrap. And then when you get home, it takes 5 minutes. I mean, you can do it when you get home, but it's best to leave it in the marinade for about an hour. So just do it before you go to work. When you get home, the vermicelli noodles underneath take 10 minutes while you're frying the chicken, which also takes like 5 or 10 minutes. And then you just throw the rest of the components together. But the thing I love about this one too, this is by Claire, who's our food editor. Very, very clever. Is the dressing, which is coconut cream and lime juice and Thai basil leaves and ginger and...
Just the right amount of chilli.
And chilli, whole chilli.
Just the right amount.
People would think a whole chilli in there, that's way too hot. But it's surprisingly just, gets mellowed out by the coconut cream. And it's got roasted peanuts in the dressing as well, and you just blitz it and put it on top. It's amazing.
And so if you're using chicken thighs and you don't... So actually, that's not going to be an outrageously expensive meal to make is it?
No. And also, the thing is with salads, I mean, I've been quite fulsome with my protein delivery here, but you don't have to have masses and masses.
No.
You just need a little bite, and in amongst it, rather than having a meat-heavy meal. So that's that one.
Speaking of meat, though, what have we got here?
So this one is with a lamb fillet, and that's only one lamb fillet for the whole salad. But you can also do that with leftover lamb if you've had like a lamb roast or anything like that. And just slice it really finely so that you don't have, you don't want it to be dry if it's a big hunk of meat. But then the thing is to add moisture. So in this one, it's got quinoa in the base, and quinoa and a tin of brown lentils, basically, and the quinoa.
And couscous would be great with that too.
It would be amazing. You could use brown rice, you could use couscous, you could use pasta even if you wanted to, all sorts of, any kind of carbohydrate base. And then it's the dressing for this one is a little bit of mayo and Greek yogurt and just a little bit of crushed garlic. So you can...
I love that.
Yeah.
I love mayo.
And so you want that moisture to go with the meat. And it's got tomatoes and olives and feta and, all sorts of other
Your fork, your pen.
Thank
you very much.
Yeah. It looks really good.
Yeah.
How's the magazine business?
Oh, the magazine.
Because it looked like we were going to lose our magazines. Mm. Dish is going so well, isn't it?
It's going amazingly well. I mean, sometimes I kind of think, long may it continue. But no, it's going really, really well. I'm absolutely thrilled. And, for us, our sales are increasing all the time. So I kind of feel like we must be doing something right, which is... for us it's brilliant. And actually, can I just mention a little thing that we quickly threw together yesterday?
To make sure it's safe for the team.
Yes, do that. Because a lot of people kind of aren't sure when they're putting the salads together, how many components to put in, how to put together a really good salad. So we've done this thing on the website from today, which breaks the components down into, the greens, the protein, the kind of carbohydrate component, the flavour boost. Boosters, the texture boosters. Nice. So you can kind of mix and match from all of the different things and just pick them. The key to getting it right, though, is to to pick up a flavour profile to start with. So like this one's got a kind of Mediterranean vibe going on.
It has, yeah, it has.
So you wouldn't do what some people might do, for example, people that I know dearly and love.
You're going to talk about me now.
You know, no, but you wouldn't put a boiled egg in it, for example, or a piece of orange. You know, you need to think about your flavour profiles, but once you are headed in a direction, you can kind of stick with that. So
I might have thrown some orange in somewhere. You could put an orange in this one.
Yeah.
But you reckon, and I hope I'm not talking out of turn here, but you reckon that this next magazine is quite possibly your best?
I think it is our best ever. I think it's got 50 recipes in it that I think are kind of pitch perfect for this time of year. I'm super excited. So I hope I haven't just put the kibosh on it by saying that. But
this looks good.
They are delicious.
I'm keeping my eye on the piece of chicken that John used his pen on.
Yeah, well, I should eat the rest of it.
Sarah, thank you so much.
Thanks, Sarah.
Thank you for always being so generous as well.
But both in terms of what you bring in and the effort you make, and also in terms of your love of what you do. It's contagious. The thing I love about Dish is that the food is good, mm-hmm. it's not overpriced, mm-hmm. and it's pretty easy to do.
Yeah.
Sometimes you feel like you're being left behind a bit.
Yeah.
You always make me think I can do this.
Oh, that's good. I mean, for me, honestly, I don't like overly complicated things. I want it to be easy. I want it to look really good and taste delicious, but not, you know, be too much of a faff.
Love that. Sarah Tuck, editor of Dish Magazine. Thank you so much.
Pleasure. Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Pleasure to have you in here with us. Me utonu mai. Stay with us. We'll be right back after the break.